And we're back. I bet you didn't think this series was coming back. I was able to solve the CTD issue with my Europa Barbarorum 2 Hayastan campaign, so I thought, let's finish it. So, last time, we were working on getting the reforms, the second tier of the reforms, by constructing Mars satrapy, a satrapy government in all of our provinces adjoining the main province, Armenia. And then once we do that, and we get Armavir to be a city, once we get it to 6,000 households, we can then construct stone wall, get Armavir up to a small city, and then we can construct royal capital in Armavir, which right now has Caucasian tribal kingdom, which was the first tier of the reform. So this will be the second tier, and that's why I have low taxes, but let's increase it just a little bit, because I think I have a little bit of a deficit, if I'm not mistaken. But in any case, in terms of the war, we concluded a peace treaty with Pontus, which had attacked us. We finished off the Atropatenian rebels, as well as the Cappadocians. We were able to defeat a bunch of Cappadocian and Galatian armies here in Cappadocia. And now we have a nice army here in Mazaka in Cappadocia. And this army is going to let's take out this remaining Cappadocian army. So they've got some Galatian swords, Galatian spears, not much cavalry except for this Iranian medium cavalry. So this shouldn't be a very tough battle. So I want to defeat that army to give us some breathing room. So then we can move against the Nabataeans. So, of course, the Nabataeans have kind of moved in here. They've taken Damascus, and they've taken Antioch, and Tarsus in Cilicia. So that gives us an opening here. I actually want to... they were actually besieging Edessa in the last episode, I believe, or two episodes ago. And they were pushed back by the Seleucids. So I actually want to see... okay, so these Seleucids have taken back Tadmor here. And the Seleucids are besieging Damascus. So if the Seleucids take back Damascus, then the Nabataean cities up here will be cut off. And that'll actually make it really easy for us to swoop in, take Cilicia and Antioch. So... yeah, let's see. It seems like the front of this war is right here in Syria. So if I can quickly defeat this army and take him down, that'll be nice. And I'll send my other spy here to Galatia and Pisidia here to kind of see what's going on. So it seems like the... we've discovered the Temple of Artemis. That's nice. It seems like the Ptolemies are making a ton of money with their provinces in Asia Minor. And it seems like the Seleucids still have control of Phrygia here, Ipsos. But other than that, it seems like, yeah, the front of the war is here in Syria. So I've got to move quickly. I'm going to gather all my troops, except for these... injured units, and let's destroy these Cappadocians here, and once we get these Cappadocians, that'll give us some breathing room, I think, to reform our troops and move against the Nabataeans, which will be nice. That'll be our first war with a major faction. And I think I have to keep expanding, because if I want to keep constructing buildings at this rate and keep and build up my army, let's start deployment, then really I'm going to have to keep on expanding. So our infantry is doing okay here. Actually, we'll put these guys on the right. It won't be that tough to beat this enemy army here. I've got 3 units of cataphracts. So I'll put my cataphracts on the right as well. I'll keep my other cavalry here in reserve. Or actually, I'll use the horse archers as well. But I'll keep the Cappadocians and the cataphracts in reserve. I don't think I'll need them. So let's get our horse archers up there quickly to start pelting them. Move the cataphracts up the hill as well. Let's get our infantry to move forward. Let's get our infantry to move forward quickly. And I think this battle should be fairly straightforward. They only have 1 unit of cavalry. They don't have too many. They only have a couple of skirmisher units, so I don't think they can handle my horse archer tactics here, which is fine. Keep moving forward, guys. Let's pound their right flank here. Infantry. I guess let's move forward and engage along their front line. Not the Iranian cavalry. And then we'll have this infantry unit move against their Cappadocian cav. And actually, you know what? We'll use the cavalry reserve to crush this Cappadocian cav unit here. Armenian spearmen, you go against them as well. They didn't get a good charge off. So we should be doing okay on that front. Let's get our cataphracts in there. Infantry, start running. Okay, our cavalry charge did the trick. So, our cataphracts are moving against their Iranian cavalry, which is good. Okay, cavalry, let's get a good charge off here against the enemy skirmishers here. Yeah, we got them to rout, very nice. Okay, it seems like we have them on the run here. Which is very good. Wait, guys, keep going. Sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt your defeat of the enemy Cappadocian cav. Okay. So we're okay on that front. The cataphracts are doing okay. You know what? I need to support my cataphracts here, because I have a bit of a bad position against their attacking medium cavalry. Okay. Very good. So we crushed the enemy rebel army. And we didn't lose too many troops, I don't think. Caused a nice mass rout. Yeah, they were crushed. Okay, let's check our troop counts. Yeah, everything looks nice. Okay, so Mazaka definitely needs more of a garrison here. So actually, I'll put that phalanx group in there. Perhaps who else can go? These Galatians need some retraining. Okay, we're at 50. Perhaps I need a governor. Okay, I think we need perhaps Mahed here to go into the city. He doesn't help at all. Not even a little. Okay, so we're gonna need some real troops in there. Okay, how about the Cappadocian spearmen? Okay, now we're at 60. This unit of Armenian spears, we're at 70. Okay, so that seems to be okay. I suppose I'll put in my cataphracts as well, because I want to retrain them. Okay, and then once we get the military occupation constructed, things will be a lot better in Cappadocia. Let me double check their buildings here. Yeah, seems normal. Seems okay. All right. So let's get these troops here to the army. We've got this group here. I'll send them to the army as well. They'll get there in a couple of turns. And that's very nice. With those troops, this army is going to be very nicely equipped. So we can take down the Nabataeans here. I want to move my spy back to Kilikia. Alright, so you know what? I'll move my army a bit closer to the border. If I see an opening here, I'll go and take it, even without regrouping as much as I want. But in any case, things seem to be going quite nicely here. We're getting some more units retrained. Our capital is going to be done growing quite soon, perhaps next turn. And yeah, we're going to get more satrapy buildings constructed once we get a little more money in our coffers. So yeah, let's end the turn and see what happens here. Okay. So, Mazaka, yeah, the public order has gone down, unfortunately. So, let's double check here. This Ptolemaic army is not moving. I don't know why. That's really annoying. The Suebas are at war. I retrained some medium cavalry. I've got a new family member. We're doing pretty well. We got garrisons and way stations constructed in Armavir, the capital. Oh, we've got a bunch of guys here. We've got a bunch of new family members. So let's keep these guys in the capital because I have a school here. If I'm not mistaken. No, I don't. My school is in no, I do have a school here. Okay, so I'll let these guys get schooled. Yeah. That'll be good. Keep the troops coming. Let's put these Colchians. Or actually, I'll put this unit of Armenian spears in Mazaka. Okay, we're at 65. How about another unit? Still at 65. All right, you drive a hard bargain. One more unit. Still at 65. Okay, the last unit. Still at 65. Why are you being so fussy here? You know what? How about this? This horse archer unit. Still at 65. If we put these Galatians, still at 65. What is wrong with you? Okay, Colchians, go in there. Still at 65. I'm very confused. Cappadocian cav? No. This one? No. Mehed? No. Everyone? Everyone get in there. What is wrong with this place? I don't understand. If they're gonna riot, I'm gonna get my family members out of there. Okay, you know what? One more idea. Let's get this unit in here. Nope, doesn't work. Okay, you know what? Cavalry. Or, sorry, that's not what I wanted to do. Okay, so I guess I'll get my better troops out of the city here, because I don't want anyone to I don't want to incur casualties unnecessarily. So we've got a pretty good army outside Mazaka. Mazaka's at 35%. I want to get it back up to 65, so I'll put my Armenian spears back in. We're at 65. And this one too. I don't know what to do about that. I guess I need to get the military occupation constructed. This is very strange. Settlement details. It's just unrest. Yeah, and the garrison bonus is maximum 60%. So, nothing I can do about that right now. But in any case, hopefully I can hold the city with no problems. And hopefully this Ptolemaic noble gets out of there. Let's see. So we're getting a satrapy constructed in Kabalaka next turn. Ganzak, not yet. I don't have enough money. And Trapezus will get it soon as well. Okay. Okay. So yeah, I'm gonna keep my family members until, I guess, until they're 20 or so. so that they get schooled and they don't get stupid traits. And our spy, where's our spy here? So I'm gonna finish exploring here. So Pergamum seems to have carved out a nice little kingdom here for them. Yeah, they have Nicaea as well, and Byzantium. Interesting. Interesting indeed. But yeah, it seems like this is the Pergamene kingdom. The Phrygia still remains a Seleucid province. And yeah, I'm raring to take Kilikia. That'll give us a nice port on the Mediterranean Sea. And that'll be a good jumping off point to take Antioch, which will really... oh, I see that the Nabataeans have quite a bit of force here. They have a nice army there. So I've really got to reform my troops here and get maybe a second army going. But let's worry about that next turn. Okay, so this year in history, yeah, a bunch of stuff happens in the West. Okay, we have to pay our tribute to keep the peace with the Seleucids, and that's fine with me. So satrapy is getting constructed. Okay, it's also getting constructed in Trapezus now. Shamushat, Samosata is going to have it finished next turn, which is nice. And we got military occupation constructed in Mazaka. Okay, so now things have calmed down. That's very nice. And we didn't have riots, which is very good. So I guess all that was needed was the military occupation, and things calmed down here. Very good. Very good indeed. So it seems like the Seleucids and the Nabataeans are still fighting in this area. And the front is here. That's a bit too close. I don't want to fight a giant Nabataean army right now, because this is my only army that's actually up to snuff at the moment. I've got to get another army going here. So let's get these guys into Cappadocia. Yeah, these spearmen. And we'll build up our forces here along the border. And perhaps if I can catch them off guard, I can send my second army to take Antioch straight away. So let's join this army. Let's see what we can retrain. Okay, let's retrain that phalanx unit. Things seem to be going well. Okay. We've got this. These Armenian spearmen are doing pretty well. So let's get these guys out of the city and have them join the army. Okay, that was a bit too much, it seems. Though public order's at 70%. You know what? I'll get this Cappadocian cav to go back in, and I'll retrain them as well once I have the funds. But in any case, we've got this second army here. So you know what? I'll have the heir, the faction heir, take command of this second army. What troops do we have now? Okay, so we have some Cappadocian spears and Armenian spears in Anikamath that are ready to go, so I'll send them to join the second army. Okay, we've got a bunch of units in the capital. Some archers, some Chaldean spearmen. So I'll get these guys to join the army in the south there, which is very good. Do we have any other spare forces? Not really at the moment. Just have to keep retraining and keep constructing satrapy buildings. Let's check the capital. Oh, next turn we'll have enough money to upgrade the settlement. Or we'll have enough population to upgrade our capital, which will be very nice. Hopefully I have enough money. I don't think I'll have quite enough, but everything is going great. So let's end this turn, and let's see what the Nabataeans and Seleucids have planned right here. I'll get this guy to spy on Kilikia. Yeah, I'll get this guy to spy on Kilikia. And I'll keep an eye on what the Seleucids and Nabataeans are doing near Antioch. Okay. So it seems like the Seleucid army has retreated from Antioch, which is normal because it was much smaller than the Nabataean army. We've got retrained. The Nabataeans are distrustful, and they should be distrustful. We've got a Seleucid army up here. Perhaps they're coming to reinforce the Seleucid army near Edessa. Let's get these troops in. Okay, we've got this heavy infantry unit, but I can't retrain them yet. I have to finish constructing satrapy, and then I'll be able to retrain those guys, the Faiza Rashka. And let's check on the capital again. Yeah, we can construct stone wall and upgrade the settlement. That's great. So let's do that. Mazaka seems to have a bit of a problem here. We've got a rebel army as well. Let's take these guys out. Okay, that's a tiny army, but I don't want to lose troops unnecessarily. So I'll go in there with my cataphracts, and I'll mop those guys up. And with the horse archers as well. So let's start deployment here. Get our cataphracts and our horse archers in order. Sorry, okay. Let's start this battle. Let's see where they are. Okay, let's get our horse archers to rush in there. And our javelin cav as well. And our medium cavalry will move in a bit more slowly to preserve their, their stamina. The horse archers ride. It's glorious, like Ocarina of Time. Okay, so let's check on what the enemy's doing here. So they've got just some skirmishers and some Iranian spearmen. So not a big problem here. So let's get our horse archers in on the flank there to start pelting them. Okay, guys, you pelt them as well. Very good. Okay, it seems to be working. Infantry, you guys come in just in case, for support, come in slowly. I don't think I'll need my infantry for this battle, due to the composition of the enemy army. Oh, my skirmisher cav has taken some javelin hits here. That's unfortunate. Okay, skirmisher cav, get out. That was unfortunate. Okay, heavy cav, let's move more quickly here. Let's get our horse archers in on the flank. Come on, guys. Work on your Parthian shot. Okay. So let's charge in with our cataphracts and move the medium cav in on the right as well. Have our horse archers pound from the flank here. Let's see our glorious charge. Come on. Very good. Quite nice. Quite nice. This is just a great looking half cataphract unit. Very nice work on that one. Okay, very nice charge there. So we've got our cataphracts in here. Let's get our Cappadocians to throw javelins and charge as well. Cataphracts, yeah, throw your javelins. Very nice. Okay, we got those guys to rout, which is very good. Yeah, those guys are routing. Enter the battle with those Iranian spears. And cataphracts charge in from the back. Okay, horse archers, go chase those guys. Other horse archers, chase these guys. Okay, and we finished them off. Very good. So thank you to the user, the subscriber, that reminded me that in Medieval 2, when you beat a rebel army, they're gone. They rout completely, so I don't have to run them down completely every time. It was something I just forgot about Medieval 2. So good, we got those guys. So Mazaka's at 60% here. So I really have to, perhaps I have to garrison with some more troops, but I'm really not sure. How about this javelin cav? Okay, that's up to 65. Is he going to be stuck at 65 again? Actually, let's check the settlement details. The garrison's at 45%. So, you know what, the medium cav. Okay, these horse archers. I'll move these horse archers into Mazaka, and that should be 70%. Okay, so that's not so bad. No, that's quite nice. In any case, okay, cataphracts too. In any case, things seem to be going all right, but I do have to construct satrapy building in Mazaka here. So, or not satrapy, but strategii, a governorship here in Mazaka, so that I can keep my public order up. So Captain, okay, he'll join my army there. Very nice. Okay. It seems like, okay, queues are stalled, but we have satrapy being constructed pretty much everywhere except for Gazaka. We are upgrading Armavir, which is very nice. Our sons are getting schooled, getting some education, which is very good. And yeah, things are going all right. Let's end the turn and see what the Nabataeans have planned. Okay, so in that end turn, we got map information and trading rights with Parthia, and the Parthians seem to have moved in the north. So that's unfortunate. I would have liked them to fight the Seleucids in the south, but that's okay. I mean, they are nomads after all, so that's their choice. Our queues are stalled, but we are constructing satrapy and Gazaka finally. Once we get stone wall constructed, I think in Armavir we'll be able to construct the royal capital building. In any case, we got a mistress for her hike, so that's okay. Parthia is distrustful. All right. Let's get our... Okay. So it seems like the Seleucid army here and the Nabataean army are going to fight near my border. It seems like the Nabataeans are going to win. The Nabataeans seem to have a bunch of Iranian troops as well, so maybe that's giving them an advantage there, besides their numbers. But in any case, let's check on my armies here. My armies, they're not so bad. They're pretty good. I just want this Nabataean army to get a little bloodied from their conflict with the Seleucids before I take them on. But in any case, we gotta finish our building program here so that we can fully flesh out our armies. But Mazaka here is at 100% public order, which is good. Okay, these, okay, I can retrain my guys now. Very good. And who can I not retrain? My cataphract. So I'll send my cataphracts back to the capital to get retrained. Who else? The Armenian spearmen. I'll send them to Anikamach to get retrained. And, yeah, things seem to be okay. Once I get the Strategii, I can also retrain my Cappadocian spearmen. I can't recruit Armenian units here in Cappadocia for obvious reasons. So, yeah. Samosata is okay. Yeah, everything seems to be all right. I want to save my money for retraining. And for, oh, so these, this Armenian horse archer unit, I'll send that to Anikamach as well, so I can retrain them. Yeah, so everything seems to be quite all right. So let's end the turn and see what happens between these Nabataeans and Seleucids. Okay, so, yeah, I don't know what happened, but there's another Seleucid army in Syria, Oh, the Seleucids went to besiege Kilikia. How dare you? So this army, this spy here, I want to find the Nabataeans. I wonder if the Nabataeans were defeated. No, the Nabataeans are in Edessa? This war is very messy. Okay, so what I want to happen is I want these Seleucids to get out of Kilikia and Syria and fight the Nabataean army near Edessa. So that leaves this area wide open for me. And I don't know what is Epirus doing here? Okay. It's not Pyrrhus, it's Pyrrhicus. So almost Pyrrhus, but I don't know why they're here. Interesting. Very interesting. But, okay, our king is now an attuned governor in the capital. That's very nice. I don't have quite enough money to retrain my cataphracts at the moment. But our stone wall is still under construction. Our satrapies are almost done here. I can retrain my heavy infantry. Very nice. Oh, and I can train this Cartvelian swordsman unit. So you know what? I'm gonna do that. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. And then I'll send those guys down here to join the second army. This unit got retrained, so I'll have it join the army. Mazaka, I've got my strategii, my governorship being constructed, so that will definitely improve the situation here. It seems like... Can I retrain them? No, not quite enough money. But in any case, it seems like all the big building projects have been paid for, which is very nice. So now I can spend more money on retraining. And then what I'll do is I'll retrain all these guys in Armavir. I will finally send these noblemen, these educated noblemen out of the city with these troops to join the second army and the first army. And then we'll declare war on the Nabataeans and see what we can get from them. So let's end the turn and see what happens. Okay. So, we have to pay the Seleucids again, unfortunately. But it seems like the Nabataean army is back. It seems like they've lost some troops here. Let's get in a bit closer. Okay, our spy got in there. Very good. Okay, it seems like they've lost a bunch of troops, which is very nice. So they have some Iranian cav. What are their bodyguards? Not very good. Nabataean bodyguard lancers, not nearly as good as ours. There's a Ptolemaic noble, Ptolemy, again, in Kilikia. And the Seleucids are nowhere to be found. Okay, let me double check on diplomacy. Let's see. The Seleucids are at war with the Ptolemies right now. Okay, so I definitely don't want the Ptolemies to besiege Kilikia. I don't want them to take it before me. If they do, I'll go and make a beeline. Or you know what? I'll declare war on the Ptolemies. I don't care. Yeah, why do I care? If the Ptolemies take Kilikia, I'll declare war on the Ptolemies, and I'll take their rich Asia Minor provinces that are not that well defended. And that'll be great for me. And that'll allow the Nabataeans to continue their fight with the Seleucids. And yeah, that'll be okay. Okay, so why is this Epirote in Cappadocia? I don't understand. Okay, so we've got another unit of medium cav ready. Very nice. Okay, so we've got this horse archer unit retrained. I'll send you to the second army. Armenian spears are being retrained. Okay, we've got a couple of nice units ready in Kutaisi. I'll send you guys down to the second army. Very good. And Armavir is almost done with the stone walls. Can we retrain anybody yet? Yes, we can. We'll retrain our Armenian spearmen. And you know what? I'll send these Akkadians down to Samosata because I don't think I can actually retrain them in the capital. Yeah, no, I can't. So I'll send them down to Samosata to get retrained. And yeah, let's see exactly what the Ptolemaic army here is planning. Okay, since they're fighting against the Seleucids alongside the Nabataeans, perhaps they won't besiege Kilikia. So let's end the turn and see what happens. Okay. The king, or the heir, Seleucos, is in Kilikia. There's a Ptolemaic army in Kilikia. There's an Epirote nobleman in Kilikia. There's a rebel army, and there's a Nabataean-controlled city. Very confusing. And now the Nabataean army is up here, near me. This is not making any sense. But it does seem like the Nabataeans might want to start a fight. So you know what? I will move this second army here a bit back near Anikamach. I'll send this Armenian spear unit as some reinforcements. I think this army should be good enough to beat the Nabataeans. I have a bit of a cavalry disadvantage in this second army, but my infantry is good. Good enough anyway. And I don't want to get involved in this mess here. Just yet, I want to see how this plays out. I can't retrain anybody at the moment. Okay. But everything seems to be okay. I'll be done in just a couple of turns with the stone wall in Armavir. 3 turns for the satrapy in Gazaka. Kabalaka finished its satrapy building. Does that add any interesting units to recruit? Not particularly. And Kutaisi's done with that as well. Samosata as well. Trapezus, is done next turn. Very nice. Mazaka has got 2 more turns until it gets Strategii. So we're doing pretty well. Let's end this turn here and see what happens in Kilikia. Okay. So we've got Another satrapy finished in Trapezus. Does that give us interesting units to recruit? Iranian cavalry, Greek cavalry. So let's compare this cavalry here. Oh, so the Iranian cavalry seem to be a tiny bit better in melee and a bit cheaper, but the Greek cavalry is pretty good. It's a little better, but they're a little slower than the Iranians. Okay, so they're about the same. Interesting. And then once I construct this foreign military garrison, I can construct some more. Okay, just your basic Cappadocian units and Galatian units in Trapezus. Okay, so the cavalry is the interesting part about that. But, our spy here. Okay, let's see what happened in Kilikia. Nothing? You know what? I wonder if I can just swoop in there and besiege Tarsus. I can't find the Nabataean army. I don't see them. Which I guess is good, but you know what? This army is more than capable enough of defeating any Nabataean forces here. So you know what? I'm going to declare war and attack Tarsus. Let's do this. So let's construct a ram, a siege tower, and some ladders. Okay. You know what? I think I can assault them because I have such a good advantage, and they have a lot of cavalry. So it's not like they can defend the walls very well. And these phalanxes are not very good at defending walls. So, I think this will be good. So we're at war with the Nabataeans now. Our army here, our second army. Okay, I want to retrain these Acadians. And I guess I'll, these Galatian spears, yeah, they're a bit better, a bit worse on defense. Oh, so I've got Armenian heavy infantry available now. So you know what? Yeah, the Persian heavy spears are they're not even as good as the Armenian spears. This Armenian Royal Guard unit it's like one of those archer plus swordsman type units. So that's actually pretty good. I want it. Oh, and I've got access to Aorsian horse archers, which are better than the Armenian horse archers because they have higher missile attack and they're better in melee as well. Oh boy. Oh boy. Okay. And I can make more cataphracts too. But I do want to save a little money because next turn I'm going to be able to construct a royal capital in the capital. So, Okay, you know what? I'm going to make one of those infantry units because that'll be very nice. And I'll have them join my second army here. And I'll keep this army, I guess I'll keep them there. It's a good middle ground here to protect against the enemy. And if I can assault the Nabataeans next turn and the Seleucids don't move, the Seleucids might reinforce me, which will be nice. So I think everything is going very nicely. I want to save up my money for that special building. So perhaps I'll leave it at that for this turn. Let's end the turn and see what the Nabataeans do in response. Okay, we've got a bit of a problem here. The Nabataean army is right there. But my army is pretty good and is pretty much ready to take them. I'll get these two troops in to reinforce. Yeah, so this army is actually ready to take on the Nabataean army there. The Nabataeans... their army's not bad, but I have better infantry, I think, and I have better cavalry. So, yeah, pretty self-explanatory there. The capital. Can I construct royal capital yet? I think, no, I needed to finish satrapy in Gazaka. And these guys besieged Gazaka. How dare you? So you know what? I'm going to get one of my guys over here. Where's my army here? Okay, this guy is 20. I think he's educated enough. Yeah, man grown. He's got geomancer. Oh, that's not good. Okay, so you know what? You're stupid anyway. You come down here and crush this rebel army, please. What is it? Oh, it's just a spear unit, light spear unit. So, yeah, I'll just fight this one out. I think if I get a couple of good charges off on this unit, it'll be no problem. It's silly. It's silly. So let's start deployment here. There's nothing to deploy. Just charge at him. Yeah, this is a light Iranian spear unit, so they can't stand against my cataphracts. Yeah, and I have reinforcements coming in just in case. So let's get a good charge off here. Did we get their general? Yeah, we got their general. So that's good. Where are our reinforcements? Let's bring him in closer. Okay, you know what? Get out of there, cataphracts. This is not an experienced cataphract unit, so... and I did charge... they were running away as I charged, so that was not the best charge I could have gotten off on them. Hopefully that's not the general. Let's... get our cataphracts into position again. Come on, guys, set up. Set up quickly, and then perhaps we'll charge them again. Okay, are you guys ready? Turn around. So let's get a good charge off now. Yes, please. Not bad, but not great. Infantry, please, please come in. Okay, cavalry. Get out of there. Okay, so let's just wait for our infantry. to get in, so I'll use my cavalry to bait them. Okay, so it seems like we're almost in position here to start pelting them. Okay. So yeah, this is going pretty well. Okay, we got him. Very good. Not the most interesting battle, but necessary. But it also goes to show you that I definitely need to keep bigger garrisons in the center. Luckily, I had some extra troops in the capital, so this was not a big problem. So you stay in Gazaka. Let's finish that satrapy building. What else can we construct here? So large-scale farming, paved roads network, large market, mining center. Oh, now that is a lot of money. That's a lot of income, but that's very expensive. House of strength, foreign military garrison. Okay. Everything seems to be all right here. Okay, my army in... Okay, the Seleucids have abandoned this area here. And the main... Let's check on Antioch. Okay, so the Seleucids went to besiege Antioch. So that's okay. And actually, you know what? Since the Nabataeans are pretty free right now, or since they're tied up in Antioch and their other army is up here, I won't assault Tarsus. I don't want to take unnecessary casualties. But you know what? I'll fight this battle in this episode. Let's crush this Nabataean army here. So let me just make sure I've got all of my forces together. And you know what? You join this army as well, so that I have an extra cataphract unit. Everything's okay. So let's fight these guys. Let's double check on what they have. They have some Cretan mercenaries. Their cavalry is not great. Their infantry is not great. Yeah, they're not great. So let's crush them. Okay. So let's start this deployment here. Yeah, let's get our cataphracts in order. Okay, so we've got some good, quick, heavy infantry here. So you know what? I'm gonna keep this heavy infantry and spearmen. I'm gonna keep those good spears in the center, and the Chaldeans as well. And on the flanks, I'll have the Armenian spears. So two Armenian spears on the left flank, and two Armenian spears on the right flank. And at the very corners, and I'll keep the Cappadocian spears as reserves. I'll keep my archers in the front. Let's take a look at this Armenian heavy infantry unit. Interesting. Interesting looking unit here. Yeah, I'll keep the Cappadocians as a reserve. I've got some cavalry here. I'll keep my light cav on the right and the heavy cav on the left. And yeah, I think we're ready. So what are the Nabataeans going to do? Are they going to come at me? Let's take a look at their army. It seems like they're coming at me, which is fine. So let's get our horse archers. To start harassing them on the right there. Oh, they've got Iranian cav on that flank as well. Okay, our archers are doing pretty well. Oh, our heavy infantry are also firing arrows, and they're much better archers than my other archers, which is nice. So guys, you can brace for the enemy charge here. Where are our horse archers? It seems to be okay on the right flank here. I'll keep my Cappadocian spears here just in case to hold the right flank. Let's start counter charges. Chaldeans move against these guys. Move against the Peltasts. Okay, so, oh, they got close to my cataphracts. Cataphracts move back a bit and get ready for a nice devastating charge. Okay, we need some Cappadocian spear support here. Oh, they've got some Iranian cavalry. Oh, that was not so good. Okay, cataphracts, charge in at those guys. That was not a good charge over there. Oh. Okay, they hit us pretty hard on the right flank. But once we get a counterattack going, I think we'll be doing quite all right. So, okay, our cavalry is doing well against their cavalry as expected, but they've got some FroyoFozo in to support their cavalry, unfortunately. Let's get this cataphract unit out of there to charge again. Our infantry line is holding very well. Yeah, their Iranian cavalry are not doing that great in their constant charging of my okay, these guys, they've only got three guys there. So you know what? You guys charge those guys. Take them out. Okay, where's my other cavalryman? Okay, fight them, please. Okay, keep going. Cataphracts. You know what? What to do? Oh, my general, oh, that's not good. Oh, come on. I should have been quicker. Okay, other general, hold the line, please. Okay, archers, Cappadocian archers, get in there. Okay, we got their general. Okay, we got their Iranian cavalry there. Other general set up to flank against this enemy bodyguard unit. Okay, seems like we are defeating them. So that's the good part about this. Our Cappadocian spears did well. What else have we got here? Okay, cataphracts charge their bodyguard unit here. Come on, move in. You can move faster than that. Okay, that was a good charge, and we got him to rout. So please continue. Continue with the chase here. Seems like everything's okay. Okay, guys, come on. The heavy infantry should go up the middle and get those guys. You guys move to surround the enemy there. Horse archers. Charge those guys and then move against the guys that are running. Chaldeans, go get these regalin. Cataphracts, charge those phalanx, this phalanx troop here, or the hoplites. Okay, who routed? Oh, my skirmisher cav, that's all right. Okay, and we've basically finished them. Very good. They've got another Iranian cavalry unit. I'll charge my cataphracts at them, my cataphracts that are... Oh, and let's charge those guys. Okay, those guys are gone. The hoplites are gone. Very good. Keep the chase going. Yeah, we finished them. They're finished. That was not the easiest battle. But on the bright side, we got them. And we lost 23% of our army. But I mean, you know, this army was not very well not very experienced. And my general was not that experienced either, so it's not that surprising that it turned out this way. But on the bright side, we won. So let's keep it going here. Move in, get as many of their good troops as possible. So these guys are the Nabataean spears. You can see they're mostly light infantry, but their mercenaries were pretty good in this battle. Let's check out our horse archers chasing them down, or at least some of them. Okay, get these Cretan archers. Who else is left? Ah, the Thurioforoi. General Cav, you get them. Yeah, unfortunately, that was my faction heir. I don't know why I'm not very good at protecting my nobles, my royal family especially. But, yeah, in any case, he won the battle, so that's good. Okay, who's left that's running away here? Just a couple guys. Okay, these guys are pretty much finished. Let's get this last one. Go get him. Okay, who's left? Okay, we got 95% of them. That's good enough for me. Let's exit the battle. Yeah, very nice. Very nice. Okay. Oh, we could ransom them for a lot of money. How many? You know. I'll ransom them. That's a lot of money. Ransom rejected. Well, I tried. Okay, so we got a bunch of hoplites. So, so every time we defeat an enemy army containing hoplite units, I have the option of recruiting mercenary hoplites. Okay. So, can I? Yes, I can. I can recruit mercenary hoplites. I don't want them. I don't need them. Okay, so now Vahakan is my general. He's not bad. He's pretty good. But I think we do have to retrain our army a little bit. But actually, our army is still pretty good. So I don't think I have to do anything about that. What I think I might do, that was the big Nabataean army. So what I might do is I'm going to move this army a bit closer to the border. I'll have this Galatian infantry. Okay, let's construct satrapy in Mazaka. I think maybe I have to... Okay, one more turn. Yeah, let's construct satrapy in Mazaka. And we're at 70%, so that's okay. The satrapy will help. So I'll get these Galatians to join the army to kind of reinforce it there. And, if the Seleucids lift the siege of Antioch, I'll go and besiege it myself. So let me just make sure. We're not at war with the Ptolemies, right? No, we're neutral. Okay, so that'll be it for this episode. I hope you're happy that I was able to fix the Armenia campaign in Europa Barbarorum 2. So we are going to march towards the next step of the reforms. We were able to build Armavir up into a city. So just have to finish constructing Satrapy and Gazaka, and I think that might be enough. I'd have to check again. But in any case, we are attacking the Nabataeans, which is very good. Once we get Kilikia, I think that'll be very good for our economy. It'll open up a lot of trade routes. And it also opens up taking these rich Ptolemaic provinces that are not very well defended. So, and Cyprus too. So in any case, I'll see you guys in the next episode.